Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, if you're looking to update your PBX system, today we're going to take a look at the new Skype for Business Cloud PBX, coming to Office 365 this year, which adds phone calling capability to Skype for Business. We're going to give you an overview and demonstrate how you can give calling capabilities to your users via Cloud PBX, setting up dial-in access for your Skype meetings, and the options you have to integrate with your current infrastructure. We've seen lots of momentum for Skype for Business in the past few months, including Skype meeting broadcasts, but an important one that's been on the horizon is Cloud PBX. And I'm joined by Jamie Stark from the Skype team. Welcome.
Hey, thanks. Appreciate being here.
So why don't we take a step back? What is, for people new to PBX, what is a PBX and what's Cloud PBX?
Well, so first, a PBX is your company's phone system. It's mostly based out of hardware and it works on premises. Cloud PBX, it's your phone system in the cloud. It's modern and it's tightly integrated with Office 365. Users, they get all the phone capabilities they need. They can make and manage and receive calls at work, at home, on the road, using, you know, desk phones and PCs and mobile devices. Plus, you get great controls for IT, increasing agility and consolidating management in comparison to a traditional phone system. Plus, we can also interoperate with your existing assets, or you can subscribe to a calling service from Microsoft.
This is a big deal because now Microsoft basically acts as your phone service, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So you could buy a calling plan, one that's built into Office 365 and uses Cloud PBX. Now the calling plan is available in the US first, and then we're gonna follow up with some more countries around the world. So yeah, let me show you what this looks like. You know, first kind of a view from IT. So you see, I'm logged into my Office 365 admin portal here, and I got a bunch of phone numbers. So first thing let's do, let's grab some new phone numbers. And so we want to make sure that all this is live for you. So Jeremy, what state should we get a phone number from?
Let's go with Colorado.
Colorado, okay. And in Colorado, we got a couple different choices. You like Pueblo, you Grand Junction kind of guy.
We'll do Pueblo.
Pueblo, all righty. And so let's get five numbers from Pueblo. So we're going to add those in, and what you'll see is I get my numbers, I can actually look at them specifically, and I've got 10 minutes left if I want to go and get some more numbers for this order. For this case, this will be just fine. I'm going to click on acquire numbers.
So what if you already have phone numbers then? Is that something I can also do?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you already have phone numbers, you can port them directly from within this tool as well. You can actually see that right up at the top here, port orders under the preview. So now, if you look at this list, I've got my Pueblo numbers, and they're not assigned to a user. So the next step is, we've got to make sure a user has the ability to make these calls. So I go under my phone users, and I see here that Janet doesn't have a phone number assigned. I click on Janet. I'm going to click on Assign Number. See that Janet doesn't have a phone number assigned, so let's grab one of those Pueblo phone numbers. And then, of course, I need to make sure that Janet has a location that is set up for emergency services. I'm just going to use a default Redmond location here. You can actually have a phone number, you know, independent of location. It's one of the cool things about Cloud PBX. And that's it. Changes have been saved successfully. And so now you look and see Janet's got a phone number signed.
So Jamie, this looks really complicated to do all manually. What if I've got like 10,000 users and I want to script it?
Yeah, of course we've got PowerShell. Let me show you what that looks like. So this is just a script that we've got up and running to show the demo. Obviously, this would normally kick off from an HR system. I've got those parts kind of hard-coded up at the top, like what users we need to
enable.
Looks
like we're going to New Orleans users, and the users are all comma-separated with their email addresses.
Exactly, yep.
Okay.
And so then we scroll down a little bit here. First thing we do is we see, do we have those phone numbers for those regions in the inventory? If we don't, then we're going to go search the inventory, grab some new phone numbers, just kind of like what I did in the web console, and then we're going to take those phone numbers and then just go through a loop and apply those to the users. And there we go. You see these starting to roll in. So you see the phone numbers that are assigned to these users.
So now if you flip back to the web console, once
this
completes.
Well, let it finish. You know, okay. There we go. Okay. So we're all good. So let's go back to the web console. So now we're back at the web console, hit F5. And here we go, I've refreshed my screen, and you see all these folks have New Orleans phone numbers.
Okay.
So there we go, Got them all configured there, in addition to Janet's down there that we did in the web console.
So I have to call a phone company or something to confirm these numbers are there?
No. This is it. We're done. We've got it.
So you mean I can call, like, Alex?
Yeah, totally. So actually, I have Alex signed in, conveniently enough, here in my Skype for Business client.
Okay.
And so let me give you Alex's number. It's 504.
One sec. 504.
313-3513.
Freshly provisioned from PowerShell.
And there we go. Here's the call coming in.
There it is. It worked. All right. So I'm going to hang up. Very cool stuff. So beyond all of this, though, what can I do in terms of getting meeting numbers and phone numbers for my meetings and conferencing with Skype for Business?
Yeah, absolutely. So normally, when you have Office 365, you get a Skype link that works when you're online. So we're adding the capability to also have a phone number associated with your meetings. So that way, no matter where you are, you're able to get into your meetings, even without a computer or even without a mobile device.
Right, because normally you just get access to the meeting via the internet or via a client, but this way you can dial in with a phone number, just get audio. You don't get to do screen sharing and maybe some of the more advanced features, but at least you get the audio connection. Why don't you show us how you configure that?
Yeah, absolutely. So again, that's here within my Office 365 admin console. I'm going to click on the dial-in conferencing settings. Here are all the different dial-in conferencing numbers that I have configured. So I'm just going to click on the default one here. And you can see that I've got these set up with a bunch of different languages. So this is actually handy for if I want to have a dial-in conferencing, you know, number set up in France. I can have the initial prompts coming in French versus, you know, this one here in the U.S. having the initial prompts coming in English.
So now that you mentioned all the different countries and languages, what is the story around international support?
Yeah, that's a great question. So we're going to market in about 15 regions. And so this is where you can initially buy the service. So in addition to that, you can provision dial-in numbers in about 45 different countries. And let me actually show you how you configure this with a user. So if I go back here to my dial-in users, you see here David, conveniently enough, does not have a dial-in bridge configured. I click on him. I choose Microsoft as the provider. And then you see all the different dial-in choices that I have for him. I'm going to pick Los Angeles, click save. And now that it's been saved successfully, I can go back and I can look at my dial-in conferencing users. And there you go, David's got his dial-in conferencing settings. And so then that way, when he goes to create a meeting, he's gonna have both the Skype link and he's gonna have the dial-in conferencing ability as well.
This is really great, but what if I'm in a region where we're not offering that calling plan yet?
Yeah, absolutely. This is a scenario we called on-premises PSTN connectivity. So here, we use Skype for Business server software. We connect between a customer's existing carrier, their contract and their circuit, and Office 365. And this is what it looks like. We use Skype for Business server software to do this connection. And this is with a customer's existing on-premises telephony infrastructure. So this could be their PBX, their gateway, their session border controller. We do that connection using direct SIP, which is a thing that we've been doing for years. So it's standard for us. And then between the Skype for Business server software and the cloud, we'll use Azure ExpressRoute, which is now generally available for Office 365.
Now, what does the software look like that actually runs between your PBX and the cloud?
Yeah, so if you're an existing customer, this is just your already in place Skype for Business server or Link server deployment. Mm-hmm. If you're a new customer, you can download a set of packaged virtual machines that just implements this topology and this capability.
So lots of great updates in Skype for Business, but what's next?
So obviously we want to be able to roll this PSTN calling and PSTN conferencing service out to more and more regions around the world. We're going to be increasing the features that you see in Cloud PBX. So for cases where you have users that have requirements for automatic call distribution and more sophisticated phone capabilities. One of the great things, though, is that because this is delivered out of the cloud, all of this comes down just into your tenant, so you can just take advantage of it directly. It's really great.
So really huge updates. If you're on a PBX now and looking to update that or just add Skype for Business numbers in your meetings, really good stuff coming. Of course, all this news and more can be followed on the Office blog or catch us Wednesdays on Microsoft Mechanics. Thank you for watching and goodbye for now.